The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In the absence of clergy, let us bow our heads in a moment of silent reflection or prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Friday, March 17, 2023, Senate member pursuant to adjournment. Journal of Thursday, March 16, 2023, was read and approved on motion to Senate adjourn.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor,
55.
Reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Gianaris.
Mr. President, please take up previously adopted Resolution 510 by Senator Kennedy. Read its title and recognize Senator Kennedy.
Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 510 by Senator Kennedy, memorializing Governor Kathy Hochul to proclaim March 2023 as Bleeding Disorders Awareness Month in the state of New York.
Senator Kennedy on the resolution.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Today I rise to recognize March 2023 as Bleeding Disorders Awareness Month in New York State. We're joined by a number of advocates from all across the state of New York, including a number of Buffalonians. My friends Michael Lewis, his sister Maya Isabella Samuel, and John Alduino. They are among a number of other folks who are here to spread the word and advocate on behalf of so many individuals who suffer from bleeding disorders here in New York, affecting more than 1 in 100 people across this great state, including a wide variety of disorders, genetic conditions, hemophilia, von Willebrand's disease, sickle cell anemia, platelet disorders, just to name a few. As recently as the 1960s, there was no treatment for people with bleeding disorders. Those with serious symptoms, such as prolonged bleeding, debilitating joint and muscle damage, and organ failure, often had a life expectancy of just 40 years. Fast forward to today, and there's far more hope. With the right treatment, people diagnosed with bleeding disorders are leading full, productive lives. Part of that is due to the advancements in medicine and research that have profoundly impacted what we know about these disorders and how to treat them. And the other part is credited to early diagnosis, proper care, and ensuring patients have access to the medication and services that they need to thrive. By recognizing March as Bleeding Disorders Awareness Month, New York is aligning this observation of the National Bleeding Disorders Awareness Month and fostering public awareness and understanding of these disorders with the hope of educating New Yorkers about the symptoms and encouraging early detection and treatment. The National Hemophilia Foundation is encouraging our greater community to, quote, start the conversation this month. And that's exactly what we're doing here today. That's exactly why these wonderful advocates have joined us here in this auspicious chamber. And I encourage my colleagues here today to join me in bringing attention to these disorders with the hope that we can provide resources and start the conversation, Mr. President, that could potentially save lives. With that, I vote aye.
Thank you, Senator Kennedy. To our guests, I welcome you on behalf of the Senate. We extend to you the privileges and courtesies of this House. Please rise and be recognized. The resolution was previously adopted on March 15th. Senator Gianaris.
Mr. President, Senator Kennedy would like to open that resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor on the resolution, please notify the desk. Senator Gianaris.
Please take up the reading of the calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 174, Senate Print 636 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the Business Corporation Law and the Limited Liability Company Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act takes effect 2 years after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Dabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ortsrud, Cousins, White.
Announce the result.
In relation to calendar 174, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Martins, Matera, Murray, Oberacker, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Scarcella, Spanton, Steck, Tedisco, Walzik, Weber, and White, ayes 36 and ayes 20. Oh, Senator Griffo as well, ayes 36 and ayes 20.
The bill is passed.
Gotcha. Calendar number 204, Senate Print 1918 by Senator May, an act to amend the Environmental Conservation Law.
Lay it aside.
Calendar number 238, Senate Print 447C by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the Education Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act took effect on the 180th day, it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Sewell, Cousins, White.
Senator Stavisky to explain her vote.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. First, I want to thank the folks who worked for the past 2.5 years or so on this legislation. It was originally brought to my attention in about 2020 by the Commission on Independent Colleges and Universities, and in the ensuing days, we've worked very closely together collaboratively with the State Education Department, with SUNY and CUNY. And it demonstrates how, working together, we can make a bill better. This helps the nursing shortage. It provides up to 30% of simulation, and with the sophisticated dummies, and that's sort of an oxymoron, I guess, but come to think of it. But with the quality of simulation, we are able to allow more students to fill these slots. In the past, the colleges and universities throughout our state did not have the space for the clinical classes that are needed. So, Mr. President, I thank everybody for making this possible, and I vote aye.
Senator Stavisky to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 267, Senate Print 1361 by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the Public Authorities Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Sewell, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 274, Senate Print 1147 by Senator Kruger, an act to amend the tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 1st of April.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Sewell, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 274, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Lanza, Martins, Murray, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Tedisco, Weber, and White. Ayes 43, nays 16.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 294, Senate Print 490 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the Not-for-Profit Corporation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Sewell, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 326, Senate Print 410 by Senator Thomas, an act to amend the General Business Law.
Read the last section.
Section 25, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Sewell, Cousins, White.
Announce the result.
In relation to count of 326, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Martins, Matera, Murray, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rhodes, Rollison, Steck, Tedisco, Walzik, Weber, and White. Ayes 39, nays 20.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 399, Senate Print 3306 by Senator Hoyman Siegel, an act to amend the Business Corporation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act take effect on the 180th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 460, Senate Print 2298 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the election law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act take effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 477, Senate Print 3403 by Senator Breslin, an act to amend the insurance law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 477, voted in the negative are Senators Brisport and Skoufis. Ayes 57, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 44, Senate Print 3459 by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act took effect on the 30th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 484, voted in the negative, Senator Walzik. Ayes 58, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 490, Senate Print 3249 by Senator Bailey, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act take effect on the 30th day after shall have become a law.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Bailey to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. This past January, there was a significant fire in my district, and it ripped through a multifamily dwelling on Carpenter Avenue in the Bronx. Luckily, there was no loss of life, and the injuries have come to what we believe are minor, although there can never be any minor injury in a fire because the trauma of seeing all of your possessions leave you is significant. But the most important thing is that they all got alive, and their children got alive, and their pets got alive as well, Mr. President. But this brings a question. How come we currently don't have requirements to make sure that there are smoke alarms in common areas of multifamily dwellings? And this is something that we don't know if it will prevent fires, but it will prevent awareness, because there were certain residents who didn't get out until very late, by the grace of God, some would say, because they did not have the building-wide fire alarm, so smoke alarm. So this bill would require that in multifamily dwellings, and I believe that this is just one of the steps this majority has taken under the leadership of Andrea Sue Cousins to be more responsive to the requirements and the needs of our communities when we face the scourge of deadly fires. So I'm excited that this bill is passing today. I look forward to its eventual passage in the Assembly, and I vote aye, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Bailey. To be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 60.
The bill is passed. There. Senator Gianaris. That completes the reading of today's calendar.
Can we move to the controversial calendar, please?
Secretary will ring the bell. Secretary will read.
Calendar number 204, Senate Print 1918 by Senator May, an act to amend the Environmental Conservation Law.
Senator Walchek, why do you rise?
Thank you, Mr. President. Would the sponsor yield for some questions?
Will the sponsor yield?
Yes, I'd be glad.
Sponsor yields.
Through you, Mr. President, what does this bill do?
Through you, Mr. President, this bill allows DEC to grant the rights for renewable energy production and transmission on state reforestation lands.
And through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
The sponsor yield?
I will.
Sponsor yields.
Do you believe that this is in line with Title V of the Environmental Conservation Law? Through you, Mr. President. Article 5 addresses reforestation areas and their purpose, if okay. That's helpful.
Thank you, Mr. President. My colleague said Title 5. We're talking about Article 5. Yes, I do.
And through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
I will.
Sponsor yields.
So out of the same section of environmental conservation law, it reads, in order to provide for the acquisition of lands outside of the Adirondack Park and Catskill Park, which are adapted for reforestation and the establishment and maintenance thereon of forests for watershed protection, the production of timber and other forest products, and for recreation and kindred purposes, the department may acquire in the name of this state a gift, purchase, or appropriation, reforestation areas which shall consist respectively of not less than 500 acres of continuous lands, which shall be forever devoted to the planting, growth, and harvesting of such trees as shall be reforested. The question is, how are solar panels in line with that purpose in that section?
President, the law already allows DEC the right to have oil and gas production on these lands. I believe that green energy production is more compatible with our forests and protecting them in the long run. This doesn't prescribe that any production has to occur on these lands. It just makes it possible for DEC to offer those leases.
Through you, Mr. President, if the sponsor would continue to yield.
The sponsor yield?
I will.
Sponsor yield.
You brought up gas and oil, which generally have a relatively small footprint, but I noticed that your legislation is allowing for wind production, which would also have a relatively small footprint as long as the turbine could be so far above the trees, but also solar. And through you, Mr. President, my question would be, why would we want to replace acreage that is specifically set aside for reforestation with solar panels in this state?
Through you, Mr. President. So as it says in the bill, to the extent that this would interfere with any of the purposes for which the land was acquired, that would not be a possibility. But there are certainly reforestation lands which are not covered with trees where they could put solar panels. But the main goal here probably is for transmission, because we are finding that when you have solar and wind production in one place and then state lands in between, it's very hard to do the transmission across those areas.
Through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
The sponsor yield? Sponsor yields.
So transmission has already been prescribed by this legislature as an exception, as has communications, wiring, and various other things. You brought up oil and gas leases, so I don't accept that answer. Does this legislation limit the number of acres that you would substitute reforestation with solar panels in the state of New York?
Thank you, Mr. President, as I just said, any activity that interferes with the purpose of the land that was for which it was leased couldn't be interfered with. So that would be on a case-by-case basis decided by the DEC.
Through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Did the sponsor yield? Sponsor yields.
Would you then agree that replacing acres that are designated for forest reforestation in the state of New York, as this statute states pretty clearly, that covering that same acreage with solar panels would be counter to the purpose of reforestation?
President, I don't agree with that. This opens a possibility for a use of these lands that I think is compatible with our climate goals, which our forests depend on us reaching those climate goals just as much as our agricultural lands do and our shorelines do and our children do.
Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Did the sponsor yield?
I do.
Sponsor yields.
Are there limits on the maintenance or the size of the maintenance activities or the size of infrastructure as are prescribed here when you're talking about adding solar arrays or solar fields to what used to be reforestation areas in the state of New York?
So once again, the DEC would make a determination whether the project interfered with the goals of the original acquisition of this land, and that would determine the scale of development on that land as well.
So no limit. Would there be, through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield.
I do.
Sponsor yields.
On areas that are designated reforestation lands in the state of New York, would there be a prohibition of fences being installed around solar arrays?
Through you, Mr. President, the idea is to treat renewable energy generation the same way that oil and gas are treated, and so it would be the same, you know, there would be the same guidelines for those.
Through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Would the sponsor yield?
I would.
Sponsor yields.
Would there be any prohibition when substituting what would be a reforested forest, what would be trees with solar arrays of substations placed in the reforestation area, above ground transmission?
Through you, Mr. President, could my colleague please repeat that? I don't understand the question.
Yeah, through you, Mr. President, I would. What I'm asking is, in this legislation where you have redesignated reforestation areas, which traditionally have been used by the state of New York to reforest an area, and we're adding solar arrays to the possibility by citing if this bill passes and becomes law, have you placed any limits on the amount of infrastructure that can be put in the reforested area to support those solar arrays?
Mr. President, I can't come up with another way to phrase this answer, but I will say this is only allows DEC to create these leases when it is compatible with the uses of the land that were designated in the original acquisition of that land. And so there would be pretty strict restrictions in a lot of places, I believe, for that. But some of these lands are used for logging, for example, which would presumably clear areas of land where it would make a lot of sense then to solar production or wind production when you've got that land that's just been cleared.
Through you, Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Would the sponsor yield? Sponsor yields.
So you've evoked the Department of Environmental Conservation a number of times today. Was this prescribed in the scoping plan from the Climate Action Council for which the DEC sits as a co-chair?
Through you, Mr. President, this bill predates that scoping plan, but it is certainly compatible with the goals of the Climate Leadership and Community Protection Plan.
Mr. President, would the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
I would.
Sponsor yields.
Did the DEC give you a reason that they didn't include this proposal that you're bringing us here today in the scoping plan?
So, as I said, this bill predates that. The scoping plan is more general, doesn't have this kind of level of specificity, but also puts forward the idea that we need more green energy production, as well as that we need to protect our forest resources.
Through you, Mr. President, will the sponsor continue to yield?
I will.
I'd say, it's generally over 400 pages. It also includes a lot of specifics. This bill that you're bringing to this chamber today isn't one of the specifics that it's included in the Climate Action Council's scoping plan. What factors in the scoping plan included the state's forest lands for carbon sequestration.
President, I don't know the answer.
A little more concise through you, Mr. Thank you, Mr. President. The draft scoping plan laid out a number of items after a long deliberation from the chairs of the Climate Action Council, many of which I disagree with, but there was one interesting note, and that is of carbon sequestration. And I think to our conversation here today, when we're talking about reforested areas and how they're going to be used in the state of New York in the future, the Climate Action Council has said that forest lands are significant when we're talking about our goals to sequester carbon. So I wonder how this bill here that you bring today is in line with what the goals of the Climate Action Council are.
President, the Climate Action Plan and our climate goals are interconnected. We need to produce energy. We also need to protect or sequester carbon. Those are not necessarily incompatible, but we need to do it in an intelligent way. There are 600,000 acres of reforestation lands in the state. This is not our old forest. This is land that was cleared for either agriculture or logging, is being reforested now. As I said before, in mostly what we would expect probably on these lands is not that they would be somehow cleared for solar production, but they would be used for transmission or connectivity between green energy projects, which many of which could be sited in pretty remote places. So this puts an extra tool in the toolbox of those who are trying to implement this very complicated and ambitious law.
Thank you, Mr. President. Would the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
I think it's our job to deal with the complications and nuance of this law or the proposals of the Climate Action Council. I wonder, why would we promote the DEC's ability to put solar panels over what would be future forest in our forest reforestation areas over things like brownfields or rooftops for solar?
Through you, Mr. President. The DEC is bound by our climate goals to weigh the pluses and minuses of any action it takes with respect to the impact on climate. And so they would be taking into account the value of reforestation or forest sequestration and the value of green energy production to make those decisions.
Mr. President, I'll go on the bill.
Senator Walzik on the bill.
So this piece of legislation that's been brought here today, as for those of you that have been paying attention, is not in line with the Climate Action Council's goals. The sponsor said it predated the Climate Action Council's work, and so it makes sense why it's not in line with their goals. In a 400-plus page document, they actually went the opposite direction of this legislation that's been brought onto the floor here today. There's a storied history of forest preservation and reforestation in New York State. If you go back into the late 1800s, we had nearly clear-cut all of New York. We had extinct the turkey. The white-tailed deer was gone. There was almost nothing left in this state. And great conservationists in this state saw the mission to bring forests back because they saw how big of a danger this was to our entire ecology. One of those is Franklin Hugh. He was referred to as the father of American forestry. He was from Lowville, New York, and he saw the devastation that the logging industry had done across upstate New York because they weren't being responsible in replacing the forests and replanting the forests after they had clear-cut them. But it's not just him, and it's not just the long history of this state. Recently, the Environmental School of Forestry in Syracuse put out a paper that said 15% of the U.S. annual carbon emissions are offset by the forest lands. Forests, and this is their words, forests store carbon in trees, leave soil where it can be sequestered for years to centuries. And it makes sense. If you're turning that carbon into a wood product that can become the desks that you're sitting at or the panels behind me, that carbon is forever sequestered so long as we don't have another Capitol fire like we did in 1911. Forests provide negative emissions, which is, this is the reason why the Climate Action Council tuned in to forest preservation and reforestation areas. Forests converted to other uses will lose carbon stored and have much less capacity for sequestration. That's SUNY ESF saying, actually, you don't want to have solar panels in an area where you should have forest. They're saying the exact opposite. You should incentivize growing of forest and good forest management in order to sequester more carbon. Reforestation has very large benefits. This bill directly conflicts with the environmental conservation laws we laid out earlier. The purpose of reforestation is to grow forest, not to grow electrons with Chinese solar panels. And the religious dogma of electrification sometimes comes into this chamber and misses it on the policy. It misses the forest for the trees, if you will. This bill is bad for our forests, it's bad for our planet. It is short-sighted, and I hope all of you will join me in putting it down today and voting no.
Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Seeing and hearing none, debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ortsur, Cousins, White.
Senator May to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I thank my colleague for calling attention to this bill and for a spirited debate. And for mentioning my alma mater, the SUNY College of Environmental Science and Forestry. We're very proud of the forest research that's done there. I believe very firmly that protecting our forest lands is important, but managing our forest lands is equally important. And we have a lot of tree species that are dying out, partly because of the climate crisis. Areas that are being cut down because of logging in these lands. We will be passing a bill tomorrow to prevent gas exploration and production in these lands as well, which I support, and I trust that my colleague will support that too. But I definitely believe that we need to be using all of our resources as wisely as we possibly can. And my esteemed colleague voted against the 30 by 30 conservation land bill that we passed, so that I think, you know, being lectured about protecting our forest lands by somebody who does not seem to value conservation is a little bit insulting. But I will just say, as somebody with a degree in environmental science and with a lot of connection to our forest preservation, I'm proud of this bill. I think this is one more piece of the puzzle of trying to make sure that we are doing green energy production and protecting our forest lands, and I vote aye. Thank you.
Senator May to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 204, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Ashby, Borrello, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Martins, Matera, Murray, O'Mara, Rhodes, Rollison, Steck, Tedisco, Walzik, Weber, and White, ayes 46 and ayes 16.
The bill is passed. Senator Giannaris, that completes the reading of today's controversial calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
Move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, March 21st at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, March 21st at 3 p.m.